Hello, Brian the Fanboy here, and today I am going to talk about Goosebumps. Now, I first started watching the Goosebumps TV series in the fall of 1995. I was 9 years old at the time. And well, as a kid, I did enjoy it. And also, around the same time, I did learn about the books. Now, before I created the books, I'll talk more about the TV show. And, well, Goosebumps was this, it was a horror show for kids, and I remember it used to air on Fox Kids. And, you know, thanks to me being a fan of Power Rangers at that time, it not only caused me, the commercials also say, you know, when it's airing. Oh, and I also remember that, I think during the first season, a new episode would air every Friday afternoon. Now, as for the books, well, I did wanted to read the books, you know, when I first learned about it, but even though my mother would bring me to the library sometime, I didn't ask for the books because, well, I thought she would not want me to read them because she thinks that, you know, things like ghosts, monsters, and magic are a bunch of nonsense. But, you know, as a kid, I was interested in reading those stories, especially since Goosebumps was indeed for children. But eventually, I did get a chance to read the books as well. Oh, and also, since Goosebumps was the Goosebumps TV series was made in the 90s, it had competition with Are You Afraid of the Dark? Yes, and just like with Are You Afraid of the Dark, Goosebumps was also a series where each episode didn't really have anything to do with the previous because, well, each episode featured a different cast of characters. Only difference was that, well, Goosebumps did not have a main set of characters that would tell the story. Instead, just go to the story right after the opening. Oh, and the opening was catchy too. I mean, with Eye of the Dark, you had like this whole scary intro with some kind of howling, whatever. And then the Goosebumps TV series, well, it would have like an upbeat tune. Yes, and I think it lasted for 4 seasons, Goosebumps did. And also in characters like Slappy and Monster Blood. Oh yes, and you know, some of the episodes were two-parters. But of course, you know, you cannot really make an episode be have everything that was in the books because, you know, they're so long. Oh, and also, even though there was no main cast that would tell the story, there were some episodes where R.L. Stine would appear and introduce himself as part of the story, but I think that was only on special episodes. Oh, and I remember for Christmas, it was 96. Well, anyway, I got, no, it was Christmas of 1997, yes, and I remember getting this, Goosebumps, two Goosebumps walkie-talkies. One was of a skull, and the other one was, I think was of the Haunted Mask. Oh, yes, and I did, two of the, Give Yourself Goosebumps books. One, something about, Jelly Sandwich, another one was for the carnival. Let's see. And after it stopped airing on Fox Kids, I think Goosebumps did air on ABC Family back when it was Fox Family Channel. And then eventually the reruns of the series did air on Cartoon Network for a while, but it was mostly for the Halloween season. And as for the movies, well, I never really seen it because, well, was trying to save my money for other movies that was, you know, for the time, but maybe one day I will see the movies. Oh, and also, I did find out that there's going to be a reboot of the TV series. Although, with the way shows and networks for children are going these days, you might have to keep an eye out for what am I putting in. But as for the old show, that's fine, since, you know, at the time when the ultra was made, they didn't put the kind of stuff that shows for children are doing putting in now these days. So if you grow up with Goosebumps and have kids of your own, then maybe you can let them watch it, you know, and they can have the same kind of enjoyment they give you, if you're a fan of the series, that is. So I think that's all I can say about Goosebumps in this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye.